Attention! Welcome back to the third episode of These Nutz Podcast. All right, Kadi.
Episode three already.
We have so much unwarranted confidence.
You're not wrong. We can do it.
I know. I'm gonna keep believing in us. Do you have any episodes for us?
Any episodes? Are you having an episode?
Cut. Do you have any updates for us?
I do have some updates.
Okay, I'm excited.
I know that last week we talked about Brian in Massachusetts. Mm-hmm. We talked about him and his crazy Google searches, and he's still in jail, as far as I know. I have no updates on him. But,
okay, tell me.
I do have some updates on our friend, Marcia.
Marcia, who was sentenced to 40 years for murder and burglary.
Yes, ended up doing 20.
Right? Yes.
If you haven't already, I feel like you're getting ready to say
yes, I was.
Go back and watch episode 2 of These Nutz. And you have to start at the beginning of Marcia, so just stop where you're at right now, go back to that episode, and watch the update first.
Okay, now that those people have left,
yes,
tell me the update.
So I spent probably 5 hours researching in one night Marcia, Shelley, Gerald, Brian, everybody that you had mentioned in the story. I really wanted to get to the bottom of, where is Marcia today?
Me too.
Where are her sons? What are they doing? Shelly had a baby, you had mentioned. Mm-hmm. So I wanted to know, where is that child? Mm-hmm. I mean, if their mother's gone.
I hope they're somewhere thriving.
Yeah. So I was on Google. I was on Ancestry. I was on Facebook. I was on a website called findagrave.com.
Okay, I didn't think about that.
A lot of information. Has a lot of, like, family ties and things like that, so that was very helpful. I couldn't find Shelly's family. I found Shelly's resting place. She is in Kokomo.
Okay.
I couldn't find her husband. I believe they were married at the time, or the baby, so I don't know. Did he get remarried? He was a
senior at Purdue at that time, so, I mean, he could have just been there for school, and maybe they started a new life somewhere else.
I tried even looking, like, the Purdue alumni, graduates.
You are a private investigator.
I couldn't. I also couldn't find Brian. I did find somebody who at first I thought was Brian, because he had the exact same name, Brian Thornton, from Indiana, and played musical instruments, but specifically the piano.
Oh my gosh, I felt like you were onto something.
I was really confident that it was him, and then I went back and was doing some digging. It's not him.
Oh, okay.
So, but I'm going to bring some pictures up. I just want to share them with you. I know you guys can't see them, but I'll be sure to add them to the video, post them on TikTok and everything. So, I did find Marcia's family. So, up there you're going to see a picture of young Marcia.
Okay.
And then I found this man, Seth, which is her son, who the only reason, well, one of two reasons that I was confident that it was him. Look at their pictures.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that same jawline.
Yes,
everything.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Like, that had to be him.
Yes.
So, when I was, like, digging through all the websites, I found that school age picture of her. And then I was able to, like, find more about her family. So, you know, she was from Plainfield, Indiana.
Right.
She, I believe, was an only child, but had two kids, Seth and Joel. Mm-hmm. I couldn't find anything about Joel other than I believe he is now located in Nevada.
Okay.
But again, unconfirmed. But basically, the trail that led me to this is I found an article, or I found some court documents that had said Marcia was discharged from prison, like you had mentioned, and was committed to Evansville State Hospital.
Okay.
So that is where I believe she's still at today. There's not really a way for me to search that.
Right.
So
sad.
So, yeah.
The whole thing is sad
on all parts. Like, mm-hmm. this woman had so many mental challenges that she was working through.
Yes.
I mean, that's what I'm going to call them. But this is kind of like the level that I was digging at. So, I'll show you. There is Marcia as of 2009.
Oh.
And her son as of 2022.
Okay.
So that is the most recent picture.
Are these Facebook photos, or how did you get these?
I did
find
those on Facebook.
Okay. Oh my goodness.
Most recent pictures I could find of each of them, which I couldn't believe my eyes when I clicked on that picture and it said Marcia 2009.
Was this on his Facebook?
Yes.
So for anybody listening, Marcia is now an old woman. She likes a velour tracksuit.
The red.
And her son, handsome fella, he likes a corn cob pipe.
Yes, he does.
I do like that.
He's got a green mustache.
Is he still in the Indiana area?
He is. He's still in Plainfield. So, how I found him, which this was probably 4 hours into research, and just like repetitive. Did I miss something in an article, mm-hmm. on a website? He was listed. I found her mother's death certificate, and the next of kin was Seth.
Okay.
And it was listed as grandson.
And good work.
Yeah, that. Work. So I thought that was impressive, but this man's very interesting. I didn't dig a whole lot into him, but he does have an IMDb.
Okay.
He's acted. He's been in 2 films I've never heard of, and also produced a film that I've never heard of. So,
respect.
He's out there living his life.
Good. Yeah, he's a brave, creative person like us.
Yeah. But yeah, I couldn't believe it. Took a lot of digging, but to my understanding, this day,
I have more questions. Did he take this picture of his mother and then post it on Facebook?
I'm not sure. This was, 13, 14 years
2009.
Ago?
Oh, 2009.
So
good point.
It looked like a digital camera picture, so I don't know if he is in contact with her or somebody had given that to him. So I'm not entirely sure, but she does love a tracksuit, it looks like.
Yeah, I love that.
So, yeah.
Wow.
I know, I couldn't believe I ended up finding her. I thought that was amazing.
Okay.
Just to kind of be able to put a little bit of pieces together of, like, where are they now?
Well, at least she is safe from herself.
Yes.
I don't think she's gonna probably be hurting anybody else in the near future based on just she's super old.
Right. I mean, couldn't decide if I was supposed to laugh at that or not.
I didn't know how else to word it.
She is very old. She may have passed away since this 2009 picture, because I mean, with COVID and everything like that.
Ooh.
I don't know. But again, she's in a hospital or a facility.
Yeah,
or
should be safe.
Home,
so
yeah. But that's my update on Marcia, so we kind of know where she's at for the most part for now. And
that's good. Yeah. That's good stuff. I put you on some detective projects before.
I think it's fun.
Yeah, most of the time you succeed, so this is a success story.
Anybody needs some detective, FBI, investigative work?
We don't give that stuff away, though. Let's wait for the commercial to come out about that.
Oh, okay.
Okay, anything else? Any other updates?
That's all the updates that I have. I don't have any updates on Brian and the Walsh family, but I'll try to keep an eye on it. If I hear anything, keep us updated.
Yeah, I think Miley's topped some more charts.
I think she's at week 3.
Yeah, amazing. I want to say she did something faster. I should have Googled it. That's going to be my catchphrase. I should have Googled it.
I should have Googled that. I'm going to make that your catchphrase. Much like my catchphrase, because that is wild, but that's not what I'm talking about.
I was thinking that.
You should have Googled it, but you know what? That's showbiz, baby.
That's showbiz, baby.
That showbiz.
With nothing else we think are funny.
I mean, I know we have at least one fan out there, so thank you for keeping us going.
You're encouraging us just enough.
Okay, do you have anything else?
No, I don't have anything.
Okay, well, I think it's my turn to start.
Yes,
so, today, I don't really have a story or, I feel like last week we both had stories to tell, and then the week before we kind of, like, were doing some digging with Miley. This time I just kind of want us to chat through some, nepotism babies.
Ooh, I'm ready. I have a lot of opinions.
Do you?
Yeah, I don't know who we're going to talk about, but I'm sure I can
form
an opinion.
I've chose five. Okay. And then I have some put together for, like, a speed round of, are they successful?
Okay.
Did they work hard? Are they talented? Have they earned their place and their fame?
Okay.
Yeah. So, I guess there's some people out there that don't know what a nepotism baby is.
Yeah.
So, basically, it's just a person that has had...
I'm sorry, I'm just pointing to my iPhone that was recording also that says... You're done. Your story just full. You're done. Okay. A Nepo baby. What is it?
A Nepo baby. Cut. Because Jake pointed out last episode that I say a lot. And I just noticed he sent me a message.
No.
Says, stop saying
I'm done with him.
He's not supposed to be listening. He's gonna embarrass me.
Yeah. Listen. You're not on the payroll. Stay out of this.
Okay, back to it.
Okay.
A nepotism baby.
Yes.
If you, like Jacob, did not know what a nepotism baby is, I'm calling you out now since you're listening.
Is it like a baby that's strawberry, vanilla, and chocolate?
That's Neapolitan.
Oh.
But I like where your head is at.
Okay. I'm sorry. Is it nepotism?
What is happening? We're just going to have a solid 10 minutes of us thinking we're the funniest people for not saying anything. Okay, a nepotism baby. A baby that has, or a person that
approximately 10 hours later.
It doesn't have to be a baby. Okay. It's a person that is born to another famous person. Is that right?
Yes. It doesn't have to be just famous people, although... Just like it doesn't. Neurosurgeon, like we talked about last week.
Yes, yes.
Could be considered a nepotism baby.
Yeah.
Whew.
I'm barely recovering.
Although, I am only going to talk about celebrities.
Okay.
Today. I love talking about celebrity gossip and tea and
I can't wait to hear who we're going to hit on.
So, as I go through this, I'm going to throw a couple pictures up for you, and then I'll add them so our fans can see as well, our little nutlets.
For anybody listening, I'll try to describe what's on the screen.
Oh, yes.
That'll be
okay.
Fun.
Yes. Okay. So, the very first person that we have...
Oh.
Go ahead and describe her.
So I would describe her as an icon.
Okay.
She used to do a show where it was the best of both worlds, really. Sometimes she was just a normal girl. Sometimes she was famous. She's got a great smile. She's got some famous friends with her.
Yeah. Those are actually her family members. So you'll recognize up in the top corner there, that is her dad. Hang on, let's back up. If for anybody that doesn't know, we're talking about Miley Cyrus.
Yes, I didn't realize she was related to that one.
She's not.
Oh, okay.
But she is.
Okay.
So Miley Cyrus, we all know her starting out as Hannah Montana. She's been in a couple of other successful movies. The Last Song, one called LOL, one movie she was a voice actor in the movie Bolt.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about
Bolt. Yeah. She's had a very successful music career. We talked about it a couple weeks ago. But she is the daughter of Billy Ray Cyrus.
Yes, but that's back in my day. He was, achy breaky.
Yes.
Don't tell my heart, my achy breaky heart. I just don't think he'd understand.
Yes, so you know him as the singer, achy breaky heart. Mm-hmm. I'm sure he had plenty of other hits before my time that you know.
That's the only one I can think of.
He was also an actor at one point. He starred on a show called Doc, which I'm not familiar with. But I guess Miley was on set very frequently when she was younger. But not only is she well connected because of her dad, her godmother, very close throughout her entire life, is Dolly Parton.
That's amazing.
It really is. So, nepotism baby, child, human, person.
Yes, I can see it.
Is she successful because of her connections, or do you think she's truly talented?
My personal opinion?
Yeah.
I think she's truly talented.
I agree.
I mean, she far surpassed her father. And no shade to Billy Ray. I love them in Hannah Montana.
The relationship.
So cute. I think that was a blessing for them, but I think it could have stopped there.
Right.
And we could have forgotten about Miley Cyrus. Except for the fact that she's insanely talented.
Very talented.
Oh, no, I think nepotism might have got her in the door. But she kicked that bitch off the hinges.
Yes,
like,
she's
amazing. Yeah.
She did. Okay, are you ready for the
next one? I'm ready for the next one.
So the next one's kind of a duo, or a pair, or a family.
Okay.
So, I am glad to hear that that is your reaction, because that is my reaction. So, do you want to describe?
Well.
Like a guessing game.
One of them grew up in West Philadelphia, born and raised.
And I bet he spent most of his days on the playground.
Yes. So, and then his wife was also an actress. So we're talking about Will and Jada and their kids, Will, Lo, and Jaden.
Yes. Okay. So the Smith family, Will and Jada, parents, kiddos, like you said, Willow and Jaden. So, Will, most people know who Will Smith is. He was kicked off in Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. He did Men in Black, a movie called I Am Legend. I'm not sure if you've heard of that one.
Yes. Yeah.
And he had a very successful music career in the 90s. Maybe going back even further, I'm not sure. But, so, he is talented.
I think going back even further.
I think so, too. Yeah. His wife, I wasn't really familiar with most of her work. She, I think today, is most commonly known for being the host on Red Tabletop. But she was also in Nutty Professor. I guess she voiced one of the animals on Madagascar. She does have a fashion label that she created, and because of Will's musical past, she had a band very briefly.
Okay.
So that just kind of tells you where we're going. But these two people both had careers in the music industry, the film industry. So then they had Willow and Jaden. Willow is known for her song, Whip My Hair.
Yes, she is.
You know that song.
Yeah, and she also,
On Red Table Talk.
Did she apply? Was there a stern interview process?
That's a great question. I would love to hear the same.
The answers to those questions.
She also had a small part in the movie I Am Legend.
Oh, once again, yeah.
You see here where I'm going with that. So I think mostly it's her music career and then her talk show with her mom. Mm-hmm. Then you have Jaden. So Jaden, as a very, very young kid, he was starred in the movie Pursuit of Happiness.
I think that sounds familiar
with Mr. his dad. Smith. Yeah. Yep. They played father and son. Mm-hmm. He was pretty popular for being the Karate Kid in the remake.
Okay.
And he has had a music career. I know he worked with Justin Bieber some, and you know, some other artists. Yeah. So, nepotism babies. Are they talented? Can they make it without their parents, or are they successful?
I barely know who they are.
Okay.
With those parents. This whole family lost me with the slap at the
fair.
Was it the Oscars?
I think so.
So.
Oh, wow. Wow. Will Smith just smacked the shit out of me.
Keep my wife's name out your fucking mouth.
Wow, dude.
Yes.
It was a G.I. Jane jump.
Keep my wife's name out your fucking mouth.
I'm going to.
Gosh, it's hard for me to give any good feedback, but yeah, I think those are nepo babies for sure.
I would agree. I can't say I'm really a fan of the family, the kids. They kind of lost me as well, not specifically with that event, mm-hmm. but I've just never really been a huge fan. Mm-hmm. I really don't care for Jada.
No, I used to love Will Smith. And I don't know what narcissistic abuse is going on in
some
this
crazy
relationship,
stuff.
But yeah, they lost me.
Yeah.
So yeah, I'm going to go with Nepo babies on that one.
I would agree. So for the next one of my favorite actresses.
Oh, okay.
Go ahead, describe. Tell
oh my
what
gosh.
You see.
She is the daughter of a very famous actress from the 80s and the 90s. Looks exactly like her mother,
exactly.
In my opinion. Exactly. But, well, both of her mom and her stepdad are both very famous.
Yes.
I personally love her. I think she's very talented, so.
Yes, I would agree. Kate Hudson, Goldie Hawn, her stepfather, Kurt Russell. I don't remember off the top of my head, but I believe even her biological dad's an actor. But just for those who don't know, a couple of things that they have starred in. Goldie Hawn, her mother, she was in Overboard. Mm-hmm. That's where I know her from.
With Kurt Russell, right?
With Kurt Russell. Yeah. They were together. Probably one of my favorite movies.
I love that movie.
Same.
It's one of my favorites because that movie's so old that I can remember watching it with my mom, who's been gone for several years. So she loved it. I love it. But I just think it's great.
Yeah, I love it as well. I didn't realize Goldie Hawn was mostly in movies and starring in things mm-hmm. between the 60s and the 2000s.
Yeah.
So I don't really know much of her other work, but she was in something for a little while called Rowan and Martin's Laugh-In. Not sure if it must be a comedy special. It started in 68.
Oh, wow. And went to 1790.
I believe that's supposed to say 1970, but yes. And then something called The House Sitter, several other things, but I'm really only
familiar
with
Overboard.
Wasn't
she in First Wives Club?
I believe so.
Oh my gosh.
Not sure. I've never seen that.
I hope that's right, but I love that movie. I'm pretty sure she is.
Then you have her stepdad, Kurt Russell. Like you said, they were in Overboard together. He starred in Poseidon. Currently, he's most recently known for playing Santa in the Christmas Chronicles on Netflix. And but I didn't realize he started acting at the age of 12.
Oh, wow.
So he's been in the business for a very long time.
Is he a Nepo baby himself?
Possibly.
I think he is. We'll have to Google
We
that.
Will. We
I should have Googled
tune
that.
Tune in next week.
Yeah.
I should have Googled that, even though it wasn't my topic. So, brings us to Kate Hudson. She stars in another one of my favorite movies of her, Fool's Gold.
Yeah.
How to Lose a Guy in 10 Days. Almost Famous. She plays in a new, I'm not sure if it's a movie or a series, called Knives Out. I'm not sure if you've heard of that.
I've not heard of that.
I believe on Netflix. But Nepotism, baby.
Oh.
Or is she truly talented?
I think she's talented.
I think she's talented,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, she's talented.
I think she is. I can't say for certainty that she would have her career without her parents.
Mm-hmm.
Her mom and Kurt have been together since the 80s, mm-hmm. when she was a lot younger, you know, a kid, practically. So
for sure, a kid. She was probably like 5, 6.
Okay. I mean,
she was born in the mid-70s, early 70s. I got real defensive about
her age,
didn't I?
So, I do think she's very talented, but possibly an autism baby.
The only reason I hesitate is because, you know, beautiful blondes are a dime a dozen in Hollywood.
That is very
true.
You
know what I mean? But, so, would she have gotten that same exposure, or the same auditions, or the same opportunities? I don't know, but I love her, and I think she's really talented.
I do, too. Yeah. Even if she is only in Hollywood because of her mm-hmm. parents, I'm glad she is. Because
me too.
I love her movies mm-hmm. and her stuff, so. Okay. Next person.
Okay, so she, too, is the daughter of both. Mother and father are both very famous.
Mm-hmm.
I remember dad from, well, you're going to say it, I won't say.
Okay.
I got to be honest with you, I haven't watched a lot of her stuff, but I'm excited to hear more
okay.
about her.
So, Dakota Johnson, everybody knows her from 50 Shades of Grey.
I'm not allowed to watch that.
I've never seen it. So,
I'm allowed, I just haven't.
Yeah, I've never seen it, but I hear that's what she's in.
Yes.
She was in Crazy in Alabama, something called How to Be Single. I'm not super familiar with her work, but I know who she is.
Right,
I know she's
too.
Very famous. Her family, so her mom, Melanie Griffith, starred in, again, I'm not familiar with any of this work, but Working Girl, something called Lolita, something called Crazy in Alabama, any of those?
I mean, I know who she is. I don't know that I've seen any of those movies
right.
either.
Yeah, I know who she is too, but not, like, mm-hmm. I couldn't tell you a single thing that she
right.
was in. Her dad, Don Johnson, again, not familiar with the man, but he was in Miami Vice.
Yes.
In
the late 80s,
I don't
want to
insult you.
I would say the late 80s, and you have to Google a picture, because they wore the sweetest, like, white suits with the chest out and some gold chains.
Okay.
It was very late 80s.
Okay.
Yeah.
He's still acting today. He's also in the show that I talked about previously, Knives Out, with Kate Hudson.
Oh.
So, he's still, like, to this day, acting, and I don't believe her mom is, but a couple of other fun facts that Dakota is connected to. Her ex-stepdad is Antonio Banderas.
Oh, ex-stepdad. I didn't realize that.
Ex-stepdad.
Okay.
I didn't know that at all.
Hmm.
I didn't list anything that he's in. I know the name. I'm not really familiar with him, but I just thought that was important to note. Another
famous figure
yes.
in her life. Yeah.
Her grandmother, so she is considered a third generation Nepo baby.
Okay.
Her grandmother's name was Tippi Hedren. She was in a movie called The Birds.
Alfred Hitchcock, The Birds.
Yes. Yes.
Okay.
I've never seen it, but I feel like if you say that, almost everybody born before 2000 knows of that.
Mm-hmm.
So...
And that was Melanie's mother? Or,
yes.
Okay.
Yeah. So, Dakota Johnson. Nepotism, baby? Or is she talented?
Well, another thing Dakota Johnson is famous for, which you may or may not know, is sassing Ellen.
Oh, yes. Yes.
It was October 4th.
October 4th. You turned 30.
I did.
And how was the party? I wasn't invited.
Actually, no, that's not the truth, Ellen. You were invited. Last time I was on the show, last year, you gave me a bunch of shit about not inviting you, but I didn't even know you wanted to be invited.
Well, who doesn't want to be invited to a party?
Well, I didn't even know you liked me.
Of course I like you. You knew I liked you. You've been on the show many times, and don't I show like?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I did invite you, and you didn't come. So
yes, this time, I do know that.
Yeah, yeah. So I do like her spunk and her spirit. I'm too unfamiliar to comment on her talent.
That's fair. The only reason I went to lead in Nepotism, baby, is, and I think I left this out, but she was in, her mom started Crazy in Alabama, and her mom's work is all from the 90s and prior. She was probably a kid at the time, mm-hmm. and she also started it. So,
okay.
When you automatically star in a movie with your with your parent, which maybe isn't fair to say because Miley, but I just feel like she's a Nepotism baby.
Yeah.
Okay, I've got one more, and then we can hit through a speed round.
Okay.
Are you familiar with this person?
Not one bit. Although the older lady's really cute, and I love her little.
Okay. I feel like you truly know all three of these people. Maybe not by name or
I do know them now that I read their names.
Okay. So, Billie Lord, another third generation Nepo baby. She is very popular today. She is in one of the new Star Wars. She starred in several American Horror Stories.
Yes, that's where I know her from.
Yeah, I figured that's where it'd be you. And then Scream Queens.
Okay.
So she's out there doing some work right now. Her mom was Princess Leia in Star Wars.
Yeah.
So everybody knows who Princess Leia is. She was also in Scream 3. She was in Hook. So her mom acted in several things. Her grandmother was Debbie Reynolds. Yeah. I know her mostly from Halloween Town. Mm-hmm. Several Disney movies from when I was younger. But she was also in Singing in the Rain.
I know her from that.
I believe that was from, I think it said 1957.
Yes, that's when I was first introduced.
Oh, yes.
Loved her in that.
And she was also in The Bodyguard.
What role?
I don't know. I was surprised to read that. But I thought it was kind of a fun fact.
That was fun.
So I included it. Nepotism baby? Or do you think Billie's talented?
I enjoyed her in the American Horror Story series, but I think someone else could have probably done just the same.
Yeah.
So I'm going to go with Nepo Baby on that one.
I would too. I agree that she might be talented or she could do, she did great acting classes or something like that, but I think the biggest thing that gets me, again, I know I'm going to say it again, but is she took over a new role in Star Wars, and that was kind of like her mom's franchise, so
did they
just see, like, we have this spot that we need to fill, we need to hire somebody, Billie Lord would be perfect because her mom was Princess Leia, so, or did she truly audition for the role? I don't know, but I go Nepotism, baby.
I'm gonna go Nepo, baby, yeah.
Okay. I don't have any more pictures, that was the end, but a little speed round, and then I'll let you take the floor.
Okay.
Nepotism baby, or talented.
Okay.
Jamie Lee Curtis.
Talented.
Her mom was in Psycho, for those that don't know. Kardashians.
Oh my gosh. Smart businesswoman. Is that an option? They're definitely Nepo babies.
They are.
But I think they milk it for everything they can.
I think they've
and
made
that's
the
very
most
smart.
Of it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I agree. Blake Lively.
I thought talented. Who are her parents?
Her dad is an actor. His name is Ernie Lively. The only thing that... I didn't really Google him because I knew it was going to be a speed
round. Sorry.
No, it's okay. We can talk about him. But the only thing that I knew of is he played her dad in Sisterhood of the Traveling Pants. Mm-hmm. But
if anything, I'd be like, that's Blake Lively's dad.
Right. Thank you. Like,
so
reverse nepotism.
He's the Nepo dad.
Nepo grandpa.
Yeah.
Okay, Tracy and Evan Ross.
I don't know Tracy Ross. Evan Ross I know is a singer.
You know Tracy Ellis Ross?
No.
Oh.
So I'm going to go Nepo Baby. I do know Diana Ross, though.
I feel like you know Tracy Ellis Ross. We're going to come back to
okay,
her.
Okay.
Part two next week. Tune in. Zoe Kravitz.
Talented.
Okay.
Yeah. What, would you have gone Nepo Baby?
I don't really know her
yeah.
enough to be able to make a decision, I guess, but... L. King.
Oh. Talented.
Talented, I would agree
oh
too.
Oh my god,
yes.
I love her.
Yeah. Lily Collins.
If I don't know him, I'm going Nepo Baby.
Okay. Her father was Phil Collins.
Okay.
Lily Collins.
She's definitely a Nepo Baby.
Yeah.
You don't get any bigger than Phil Collins.
Right. So, as I was doing some of these, I was trying to find people that I didn't know were Nepo
right.
babies. And this next one, Gwyneth Paltrow.
Oh, yeah. Blythe Danner.
I had no
yeah.
idea.
Nepo Baby.
Okay.
I don't even think she's that great of an actress.
I couldn't
And she's welcome
she
to come on the show and prove me wrong, Gwyneth.
Yes.
But I'm sorry, I'm going Nepo Baby.
Okay. Nepo Baby it is. I don't really know her enough to be familiar.
Yeah, I don't think she's... And that goop stuff.
Oh, yes. I know very little about what you're talking about.
She has a candle that scented like her vagina.
Yes.
Which I will not be burning.
Please do not bring that as a gift when you start on our show, Gwyneth.
No, I don't want that.
Emily and Zooey Deschanel.
Talented.
Talented? Okay.
Because I didn't even know their parents were famous.
Their dad is a cinematographer who just created the new Lion King.
Okay. Big time famous.
Yeah. Jennifer Aniston.
Nepo Baby.
Oh!
I know that one hurts to say a little bit. But
oh, I was not expecting that.
I know, but I'm going to stick by it. I just really am. I think I've seen more beautiful and better actresses.
Wow.
I know. I mean, she's more beautiful than I am. I'm not saying that, but I don't. I think she's a Nepo Baby.
Okay. I love Jennifer Aniston.
Yeah.
And I think she's, I don't think I've ever seen anything that she's been bad in. She probably wouldn't be where she is today without her dad.
Mm-hmm.
But fair enough.
Okay.
Last one, Angelina Jolie.
It pains me to say, but talented.
Talented? Okay. I don't know that I've ever... I know Angelina Jolie, her kids, her ex. I couldn't tell you. I know things that she's been in, but I've never seen them.
Oh, well, that's good. That's a good
so.
Decision. Yeah. And now, if we're on a personal level, I'm team Jennifer Aniston all day long.
Okay.
Okay. But I do think Angelina Jolie is talented.
That's interesting.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, well, that is all I have. Nepo babies. If I forgot any Nepo babies that I should have mentioned or any that I didn't know about or what your thoughts are on any of the Nepo babies that I mentioned or adults, Nepo adults.
So the one that I'm thinking of
yeah.
that I thought you might hit on is the Coppola family. Have you ever heard of them?
Mm-hmm.
Like Nicolas Cage.
Okay.
He changed his name. He's originally a Coppola.
He does have a lot of...
And his family's... all connected.
Yes.
So.
Yeah, I did see Nicolas Cage when I was kind of doing some research to see like who I wanted to talk about.
Mm-hmm.
And Drew Barrymore. Her line of family
We're talking
members,
the 1800s.
Yes,
I mean,
yes,
forever.
I read an article that it was
mm-hmm.
it was back almost that far
yeah.
to where black and white, not
mm-hmm.
like... They're drawing pictures for the
right,
movie,
yeah.
not just filming on
mm-hmm.
camera. So, yeah.
The Barrymores are very established.
They are. She's great. I love
Drew
Barrymore.
Oh, yeah. She's talented. So.
But that's all I got.
Okay,
so
awesome. All right. I'm going to tell you about the first Wednesday.
The first Wednesday ever? Like Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday?
Wednesday, my dudes.
No, I'm talking about Wednesday Addams. OG.
Oh. Okay. OG. So that's
yeah.
before my time because I know there's been several Wednesdays, several Addams
yes.
families.
Yes, it was before your time. And I'll tell you, I'll give you a little breakdown of what Wednesday Addams, who she is.
Okay, tell me.
So the Addams Family is a fictional family created by cartoonist Charles Addams. They originally appeared in a series of 150 unrelated single panel cartoons, about half of which were originally published in the New Yorker over a 50-year time period.
That's a long time.
Oh, I couldn't believe it, but just wait. Since that time, they've been adapted to, as we know, TV, film, video games, comic books, and a musical. So
a musical?
A musical.
Of the Addams Family?
I would go. I would see that. And I'm not even a musical person, so it's over 85 years the Addams Family has been a thing.
Wow, okay. I didn't realize it's been that long.
Originally, when they were cartoons in the New Yorker, they didn't have names. They were just those sketches of the family. So Wednesday Addams is a fictional character, obviously, from the Addams Family. And she's typically portrayed as a morbid and emotionally reserved child that is fascinated by the macabre. And she is often identified by her pale skin and black pigtails. Wednesday has been portrayed by several actresses in film and television, but I'm going to tell you about the first one.
Okay.
And her name is Lisa Loring.
Lisa Loring. She kind of then set the stage for Wednesday that is today, even like the most recent Netflix one.
Yes, absolutely.
Okay.
And this recent Netflix one, which you know I got obsessed with.
Oh, it was great. Jake and I loved it.
I loved it. And that dancing scene, which went viral on TikTok.
Yes.
Jenna Ortega, who plays the current Wednesday, the last Wednesday, she went back and watched Lisa Loring's dance videos.
This is the latest. It's called The Drew. Come on, now you try it.
And she adapted some of those moves that are
into the dance. Yeah. That's great. Wow, like really paying like her respects.
Homage to the OG Wednesday. So let me tell you about Lisa. She was born Lisa Ann DeCenses, and she was born February 16th of 1958. And she's best known, as I mentioned, for playing the child actress Wednesday Addams. She was born in the Marshall Islands, which is a United Nations Trust territory. And the reason why she was in this United Nations Trust territory is hard to say.
Say that 10 times fast.
It's the United Nations Trust territory. It's the United Nations Trust territory. It's the United Nations Trust territory. Because her parents, Judith and James, both were in the U.S. Navy.
Okay.
But they did divorce shortly after her birth. Her mom was then stationed in Hawaii, and so she spent a lot of her young adulthood in Hawaii. And then about 3 years or so, they moved to Los Angeles.
Los Angeles, the one and only.
That's right. She began modeling at age 3, and she appeared in an episode of Dr. Kildare.
Oh, wow.
So her career began. She started modeling at age 3, and she landed the role of Wednesday because she would go with her mother on auditions because her mother wanted to be an actress. And it was there that someone noticed Lisa and her potential talent.
Okay.
So her career took off, and as you know, her mother's did not, because we don't know who she is.
Not a Nepo baby.
No. When she was in the final casting stages for the Addams Family, there was approximately 10 other young girls who were also in the running. But Lisa couldn't read. She was 6, but she couldn't read.
Okay.
So she was the only one that could say the lines back and the tone that they wanted. So if the director said, Lisa, say, Lurch, let's go to the park and play, but say it flat and like you aren't going to have any fun there.
Right.
She could do it.
Really?
Perfect, yes. And the other little girls couldn't grasp it.
I mean, at 6, I imagine that's a hard thing to get a 6-year-old to grasp, to repeat to you, especially to say it with no emotion. Like,
right, exactly. So she got the part. And she just nailed it. And at that time in the 60s, the other sitcoms that she had to compare it to were like cheerful, colorful, perfect little kids. And she played dark.
Would the nice young lady like a nice big strawberry ice cream cone?
No, sir.
Well, what would you like?
A dead fly.
When she was 8 years old, the Addams Family show came to an end. And she did other TV appearances, but she was not getting hired for many roles after that. And I read that a lot of the TV shows at that time, they wanted somebody that hadn't been recycled or like on another show. They wanted a fresh face. They probably just wanted somebody cheap, honestly.
That makes sense, because that's kind of crazy to me when you put it like that, because not when they want somebody cheap, but they want somebody recycled. Because like today, I feel like they want people that are familiar, those familiar names, those familiar faces. So,
yeah, different. I mean, it's crazy how the times are different and what goes on. So, when Lisa was 15 years old, she married her first husband.
15.
His name was Farrell Fomberg, and this was in 1973. And Farrell was 18.
Wow.
And a year later, they had one daughter together, and a year later, they were already divorced.
So she got married at 15, had a daughter, and then was divorced all before she was even a legal adult.
Yeah, but it's really sad, because one of the main reasons why she got married to her first husband so young was to get out of her house.
Oh.
By that time, her mother's alcoholism was really, really bad. Mm-hmm. And there was a lot of turmoil in the house. And that just made me so sad for her.
That's sad.
Even sadder, the year after that, her mother died as a direct result of alcoholism.
Aww.
So this poor girl, I mean, can you even imagine processing, I'm a big star.
Mm-hmm.
No, I'm not anymore. My mom is really sick.
Right.
With alcoholism. Just all of those emotions and the chaos. And also, I didn't read this anywhere, but I imagine her mother being a little resentful that her career never really took off.
Right.
So.
That is so sad, especially to process at such a young age.
And her mom was only 34.
Wow.
34 when she died.
Her mom was young when she had her.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, no kidding. She was a teen mom, too.
Yeah.
I didn't even think about that.
Oh.
Yeah, so we don't know what her trauma was that she was carrying around, but... So, anyway, Lisa, then from 1980 to 1983, she played a character called Cricket Montgomery on the CBS soap opera As the World Turns.
Okay.
She also appeared in a lot of, like, B-rate slasher films.
Mm.
I know, I don't watch those.
Not a slasher person.
She met her second husband at the time. She met her second husband, actor Doug Stevenson, in 1981. And he was a contract performer on another soap opera.
Oh.
He was on Search for Tomorrow.
Never heard of that one.
Yeah, I've heard of it. It was the 80s, but I don't remember it or anything. Loring had a second daughter with Stevenson. Lisa had a second daughter with this new husband, and sadly their marriage ended in 1983. At the time that Lisa was working on acting projects, this is my favorite part about Lisa.
Okay, tell me.
She was a hustler.
Okay.
She would like go and work on these soap operas, and she'd pass the word around on the sets that she also does interior design.
That is an Amy move.
Yeah.
You're like, do this.
I'm
going to do this for you. I'm going to take you on a lift. But
yeah,
while you're in here, you mind if we listen to my podcast?
Yes. Let me tell you something, though. She was a hustler just because she liked, I think, to work. Because here's a really cool fun fact that I found. The man who played Uncle Fester in the original Addams Family, his name was Jackie Coogan. And he'd also been a child actor, but he actually had to sue his own mother, because by the time he was done with all of his acting, He had no money left.
Aww.
So he started something called the Coogan Project that protected child
actors. I was
going
to ask if that's what protects the kids today.
I think so.
It did then.
So he made sure, like, Little Wednesday and Little Pugsley had that safety net, which was Lisa.
Right.
And I don't know who played Pugsley, but... So it wasn't like she was broke. She was protected, and she was still getting residual checks, too.
Okay.
So, you know, Lisa's passing the word around on, you know, her little soap opera that, hey, if you guys need design work, I do that, too. Well, a filmmaker in the adult film industry heard about her ability to do interior design. And he would rent mansions.
Okay.
But they'd be completely empty. And so he was like, I'm just going to get with Lisa and be like, hey, we're shooting this X-rated movie here. Can you come in and do the designing? And she was like, yeah. So she would read the scripts of these adult movies because, say the scene called for a glass table or a pool table or some other prop, she needed to know
that. She had to have that.
Yeah, so she would have to have it brought in. Well, she started being like, these scripts are terrible. So, she sounds like me. She's got a lot of opinions. No, nothing to back it up. Like, so she started giving her feedback, and she became an uncredited writer. Like, she was getting paid for it, but she's like, don't put my name on it or anything, but I can help you with this. This is bad.
I did not expect it to take this turn, but yeah, let's go.
I didn't know this stuff when I started researching her. Then one day she was there on set and the makeup artist didn't come to work.
So she's like, I'll design the interior for you. I will write your script. And hey, let me just do your makeup.
Yes, you nailed it. She was like, I can do that. So she started doing that.
What?
On these sets is where she met her third husband.
Okay.
Adult film star, Jerry Butler.
Okay.
So when they first started, like, talking, liking each other, or whatever, she, like, let him know. Yeah, I feel like we're vibing. I don't know if this is a direct quote, Kadi.
Okay. I've been waiting for some indirect quotes. So
this is an indirect quote. She said to him, we're vibing, but I am not going to be with anybody that has sex with other women for a living.
Okay.
Or for free. And he said, fair enough.
Oh, okay.
I love you. I want to be with you. I'm going to leave all this behind.
Wow.
Yep. So, do you think he did that?
I did until you asked me if he really stayed true to his word. Now
yeah.
I'm questioning it.
Yeah. So, while Lisa and Jerry were together, the party scene happened.
Okay.
And Lisa already had that genetic component to addiction.
Right.
And so it exploded. And I read heroin was kind of her drug of choice, which is just so, so sad. So now money's going fast because, you know, you got to buy the drugs, you got to keep up with the drugs. The more you have, the more you need. Just the whole nightmare. So Jerry says that's why he started sneaking around and doing porn again.
So that he could provide her money for her addiction?
Because they were going through money too fast and they needed more money.
Aww.
So he would tell her that he was doing work on other sets and getting paid for that work when really he was sneaking off and having the sexy time.
Okay.
So this is in the late 80s and the early 90s.
Okay, I was wondering, like, where we were in the years when you said party scenes.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, and cocaine. I thought cocaine, because when I picture the 80s and the 90s, I picture cocaine. Why? I don't know.
That's fair.
Right next to a Furby, it's just some lines of coke.
Okay.
I made that up.
I'm sure.
So, when their marriage began to have troubles, they did what most married couples do.
Get remarried, have a baby. I know you're not going to say get a divorce because that's the only logical answer.
No, Katie, come on. It's so obvious. They started going on daytime talk shows.
Okay. That was my next guess.
I figured. So I watched the one that they did on Geraldo.
Okay.
And it was so cringe.
Adam's family is all grown up and married to a porn star.
We had an agreement that he would not, absolutely not, continue doing porno movies. I found out about 8 months after we were married that he'd been doing them behind my back.
It wasn't easy just learning how to give myself to one particular person.
Would you? It was so bad. They were on there to talk about how, I'm sorry, I'm not going on a daytime talk show to be like, well, if my husband would just stop putting it in other women, we could work this out.
I'm sorry, babe, I'm only doing it to support your heroin addiction.
Shh.
That's how I imagined that going.
It was terrible. And he seemed really high on the show. He was like kind of leaning out and jumping out of the seat and rambling real fast. And he told Geraldo, well, that's a story for another time. And Geraldo goes, what time?
When we're back next week.
Right. So, aye. Definitely Jerry was high. I think Lisa probably was also, because why else would you agree to go on a talk show?
Right.
They're probably getting paid too.
I mean, I guess if they needed that check, then yeah.
Right. It was also during this time that she, this is terrible. So, I know. She's already going through all these marital problems, addiction problems. It was during this time that she also made the gruesome discovery that would haunt her and push her toward an attempted suicide. She actually discovered the body of another adult film star, actress named Kelly Van Dyke, who had hung herself.
Aww.
This really, threw Lisa, for a tailspin.
Can't imagine.
Oh my gosh, no. If I found somebody who had just committed suicide, I don't know what I would do.
Right.
Well, I don't know why I do this, but she stole a bottle of insulin from another friend and then went home and shot all of it in, to try to kill herself. She couldn't get out of this cycle.
I thought you were talking in terms of, drug addiction. And
mm-hmm.
No. Didn't know that was a thing.
No, it was to hurt herself.
Oh, that's so sad.
Yeah. But she didn't die, obviously, and this prompted her to, really wake up. She checked herself into rehab.
Really?
Yeah. And as far as I know, that was the end of it. She got clean, and she just focused on herself and her girls.
Aww.
So, Jerry and Loring did end up divorcing in 1992, and this is the real pisser, because then that same year, he quit the porn industry.
Of course he did. You know why? Because she wasn't there to tell him not to. Because if she
would have
said...
Is that what men do?
Yes, it is.
Okay. Yeah, that makes sense. So, my takeaway, even though, Lisa's story has so many sad parts...
Yeah.
You know, she overcame so much. You know, she was raised by an alcoholic.
Mm-hmm.
She went through these troubles with her relationship.
Yeah.
She
battled addiction.
But she was still a very loving mother and beat her addiction.
Yeah.
Sadly, Loring had a stroke.
Oh.
And died on January 28th of 2023 at the age of 64. But I read that she was on life support for 3 days prior.
January when?
28th of 2023.
Just a couple weeks ago?
Yeah, just a couple weeks ago.
Wow. I didn't know that.
She was on life support for a few days, I think 3 days prior to her passing. And I read in multiple places that she passed with her daughters by her side.
Aww. Now, there's absolutely no reason for me to give an update, but I'm going to have to go back and Google that, because
yeah.
I don't remember hearing about that, and I feel like the passing of the first Wednesday Addams should mm-hmm. be significant news.
It was to me. That's why I wanted to
yeah.
talk about it. She created that character. I mean, she didn't create the character.
She set the stage for that
but
character.
But prior to that, Wednesday didn't have a name.
Right.
She didn't have a voice. She didn't have movements,
yeah.
And here she is, a six-year-old in the 60s. Able to understand the concept
right.
and really create this iconic character.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Yeah. So I just wanted to share about her. One of the other things is because, even though her story is full of tragedy, She was such a badass hustler. And Star actually suggested that we do like monthly or weekly or some at some point, like just strong women. And,
yes,
and
that's a great idea.
I think Lisa fits that.
I think she does too. Wow, that's amazing. Okay. Well, I love that. We'll have to find somebody specific to do for March then, you or I, to keep it going. That's that's really great.
Yeah, thank you so much. I really am so sad we lost. 64 is so young.
Yeah, that is very young.
To die. I mean, it's not... You acted like 64.
Well, I was just doing the math in my head, and I just imagined she was much older than
that.
No,
she was only 64 years old.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
It is very young to pass.
So I think we have a little special announcement.
Okay. Yes. I'm so sorry that I keep saying, now I can't stop hearing it.
I don't hear it at all. It's fine. I wish I didn't have this tickle. I don't know if I'm getting sick or allergies. Just
every episode.
We're going to get it together.
It's
I promise.
Okay. Every episode is better than the last. But
yeah, well, I hope so.
I think it is.
I hope so.
We just want to show our gratitude for all of our fans, our Nutlets that have been dedicated, that have been sharing, that have been commenting, liking, subscribing, and to encourage that. Mm-hmm. So we're going to do a giveaway.
Oh, I'm excited.
So we are going to hold this giveaway from tomorrow, February the 8th. Until March 1st. The ways that you can enter to win are liking, interacting with any of our platforms, any of our profiles, like our videos, like our post, like our stories, or give us a 5-star rating on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, YouTube, comment, share.
Any of those.
Any of those things.
Gets you an entry.
An entry.
And you can get multiple entries.
Yes, there's no limit. So interact, share us with your friends, encourage them to do so too. And we will draw a winner for some special These Nuts merch that we'll be posting on our Instagram. So keep an eye out for what we have for all of our Nutlets.
Yes. What did you say when we were going to do the drawing?
Oh, yes,
you did. I'm sorry.
I did. Just
March
to recap.
No, don't recap.
March 1st.
Well, thank you guys so much, and we'll see you next week.
Yes. Don't forget to like, follow, and share. And this has been another episode
of
These Nuts Podcast.
Good.
It's been another episode of
These Nuts Podcast.